Hi there, my name is Dan, and this is a free extract from my longer Dreamweaver course that's available on bringyourownlaptop.com. But don't worry, there's lots of free stuff here. Check out the description for the exercise file so you can play along with this tutorial. Also in the description, there'll be a link to the playlist that will show you all the stuff that is free as part of this course. All right, let's get on to the tutorial. Hi there, in this video we're going to set up our workspace so that we can design amazing websites. Now this particular course is going to focus mainly on the live view or the kind of more design visual side of using Dreamweaver. You can totally do this course in the code side if you prefer, but if you want to follow along exactly, okay, we are going to do this in the visual view. To do it, first of all, you need to make sure you're not on developer. Okay, developer is fine, but we're going to be working in standard. And in standard, we're gonna open up a new document just temporarily. Okay, so file, new document, HTML, none, click create. We're gonna close this down in a second. Really all we wanna do is to be able to see this. Okay, so you can work in code view in here, or split or live. We're gonna work in split, okay, which means it's part live view and part code. And the other thing is I split mine horizontally. Some people prefer vertically. I'm not sure what yours is set to. So go up to view and there's view mode. And then there's this one in here called split. And you can either split vertically. Okay, so you can see your website that side and the code on that side, either which way you like. But if you're gonna follow me, let's work on the split horizontally. The other thing is that we're gonna switch to CSS Designer panel. We're gonna spend a lot of time in here. And the only trouble with it, it's quite small by default. So we're gonna do two things. See the DOM panel down here and the assets panel and the snippets panel, they're cool, but they take up a lot of screen real estate. So we're gonna double click the word DOM, okay, to make it still down there if you need it, okay, but it's nice and small and it's expanded out the CSS Designer view. Another thing we're gonna do is if I grab my mouse and just kind of hover it just there, see those little arrows? Okay, I'm gonna click and drag them out and watch this. It'll go from one column to two columns. I find this is the best way to learn. It's got everything nice and open. And even when you're not learning, okay, when I'm doing stuff in live view, this is the way I prefer to work. Now, if you've got a really small screen, like a 13 inch laptop or 11, okay, you might have to have it tucked back in here. Okay, because it's just not gonna work. But I'm gonna have mine just out here. I've got a 15 inch MacBook Pro and it works just fine like this. Cool, so you've kind of made some settings. We've got it looking perfect. What we're gonna do is save this, okay? So that if we mess it up later on, we can reset it. Or if you plug it into different monitors, that type of thing. To do it, up here where it says standard, drop that down, say I'd like to have a new workspace. I'm gonna call this the Dan is Awesome workspace. Call yours whatever you like. And it just means if later on you're like, ah, oh, and I drag this and it joins up over there and it ends up connecting to this and you accidentally close this and this bit's gone all weird. Okay, what you can do is go up to Dan is Awesome and click reset Dan is Awesome and it kind of resets it. Everything except this, turns out. I thought it would. Okay, but at least gets everything back to normal, gets expanded out from the side the same width. So that, my friend, is how to get your workspace looking super sweet and how to save it and later on reset it if you need to. All right, let's go and actually start making a website. Hurry up, Dan.
Hey, if you enjoyed this video, please like it and consider subscribing to my channel. Also, go to Bring Your Own Laptop for the full premium version of this course. Also on that website is a free resources section where you can download PDFs, especially for this, the Dreamweaver cheat sheet. Okay, it's a PDF, you print it off, stick it next to your computer, and be more awesome. Bye now.